Injustice, Gods Among Us. From the developers of Mortal Kombat, NetherRealm Studios. I suppose it was possibly inevitable, considering that Marvel had the deal with NetherRealm's competitor, Capcom. Now, let's see. Single fight. Now, I'm not going to go into this game's story because, well, I'll do the story mode some other time, and I'll let that explain it. But let's look at our cast here. We've got Batman, Nightwing, The Flash, Cyborg, Green Arrow, Superman, Martian Manhunter, Zatanna, Wonder Woman, Aquaman, Raven, Hawkgirl, Shazam, Green Lantern, Batgirl, Sinestro, Black Adam, Bane, Doomsday, Killer Frost, Ares, Lex Luthor, General Zod, Lobo, The Joker, Harley, Solomon Grundy, Deathstroke, Catwoman, and Scorpion.
Batman, The Joker.
Just gonna go on easy just for the sake of showing things off. Let's see here. And yes, we're doing actual matches this time.
Watch out, Joker! This one looks kinda tough!
Really? I think you underestimate me.
Begin.
Joker in this game is voiced by Richard Epcar, who previously voiced him in, Mortal Kombat vs. DC Universe. Man, I haven't played Injustice 1 in a while. It's beginning to show. Come on, Joker, this way. Or was it the other way? Oh, it must be the other way. This way, Joker. Now we go over this way to do the other transition. Don't worry about me, just a tickle in my throat. How should I do the rest of this? Should I keep doing single fights like that, just with each character? Because that'll be 1, 2, let's see, 4 down, 12, 24. That'll be 30 matches if I do, and that's assuming. Alright, the other option would just be to go to training mode.
Nightwing.
Let's.
Deathstroke.
Oh, I almost forgot to show. If we go over to Nightwing and if I press square,
Nightwing.
I can pick between different costumes. Since this is Ultimate Edition, I have all the costumes in the game right from the beginning, rather than having to buy them as DLC. So I'll show off some of those. For example, here we've got New 52 Nightwing. Versus Cartoon Deathstroke.
Begin.
Now again, I don't remember how to play this game very well, so you'll have to forgive me for my suctitude. I keep forgetting, range is not somewhere where you want to be with Deathstroke. Injustice isn't rated M like Mortal Kombat does, but that doesn't mean they skip out on the violence.
You deserve that.
It's just less graphic. Nightwing is unique because he has two different styles. He can change between the staff or the Escrima sticks. If I end up missing anybody's super move, I'll go to training mode to show theirs off after I've done with the other matches.
I bring you the gift of pain.
You are so gonna regret this.
That right there is the clash mechanic. You can only do that if you're on your second health bar, and it allows you to bet your super meter to either regain health if you're the defender, or deal damage if you're the offender. Since I didn't have any meter, he was free to get back at up to 25% of his health. Though you only get that much back if you bet your entire super meter. Basically, the way to win a clash is to just bet higher than your opponent. They have some pretty neat interactions, and I won't be able to show them all, mostly because they're randomized.
The Flash.
Let's see.
Killer Frost.
Ferris Aircraft Carrier does not have a stage transition, so no need to worry about that. Just need to worry about landing Flash's super move.
Catch me if you can.
Begin.
So one of them. Huh, forgot she could do that. The Whiplash!
The Flash wins.
Okay, next up.
Cyborg. Lex Luthor.
Next up, Gotham City. I think Cyborg is more based off the comics than the cartoon in this costume.
Must I remind you of my superiority?
Though he is voiced by Kerry Payton in this game. Same guy who voiced him in the cartoon. Proton Cannon! I bet some of my super meter so he didn't get back as much health as he could have there.
Don't mess with the best.
Man, I forgot I loved this game so much. I mean, the second game is clearly better, but still. Oh, right, Green Arrow, I forgot. The Arrow costume is obviously based off the CW show and is actually voiced by his CW actor. But I honestly prefer his voice actor from the actual game, so...
Green Arrow.
Let's see, who's a Green Arrow villain here? I don't think he has anyone from his rogues gallery here. Okay, Grundy it is. Next up is... Watchtower, if I'm not mistaken.
That's what I call an entrance.
Begin.
Oh dear. Dodge, dodge. Okay, if he'd managed to grab me there, he would have done his super move on me. Now I think it's from this side we can do the other way transition. Trying to jump over you to do the transition, Grundy. There we go. Sure hope that thing was on autopilot.
Green Arrow wins.
Time for the grand finale.
Okay, next up, Superman. No, boy, does he have a lot of costumes. We'll go with the basic one. And I mean...
Zod.
Ooh, actually.
Superman. Zod.
And we're detouring to Metropolis. Superman actually has different intros for his normal and regime skins.
This planet will be mine.
Begin.
Superman is voiced here by George Newbern, if I'm not mistaken, who was his, DCAU voice actor. Ow. Well, it's certainly a lot of property damage.
Superman wins.
And as soon as he hears that cry for help, he's off to go do Superman things. I should probably do a match with Regime Superman to show off his differences.
Superman. Zod.
Start from the museum this time so I can show the transition out of there. Back to the street.
This planet will be mine.
Begin.
Ah! Okay, I'm on the wrong side. What's the... Oh, that's the heat vision one.
Quit while you can.
This way, Zod. Come on, Zod. Alright, fine. Forget the transition. Came out a little too fast. I lost.
I win. I always win.
Superman. Zod.
Funny. He actually says that during his grab.
Begin.
Well, yes, that was a Starro parasite that was in that ball, and yes, I did just set it free.
Why prolong your suffering? I enjoy spending time.
Superman wins.
Kneel before me.
That's why I picked Zod specifically for this skin.
Martian Manhunter. Lobo.
See, I guess our next option is Themyscira.
I will defend Earth.
Time to liven up the joint.
I love Lobo. I will admit, Martian Manhunter is probably the one I've played as the least. Come on, Lobo.
Red frag, destroy! Stop.
I don't know why he tried to do that. We get a look at John's true form.
Raven. Ares.
Oh, I didn't mention, but while Raven in this game is voiced by Tara Strong, she sounds nothing like the cartoon. Ares. Yeah, Raven in this game is more meant to be her Regine counterpart, who's been mostly taken over by Trigon. If you're wondering about the rest of the Titans, at least from the cartoon, or just like the most famous group of them, well, obviously Cyborg's in this game, and he appears in the sequel as... But, Starfire is DLC in Injustice 2, and poor Beast Boy hasn't even made a physical appearance in either of these games. Partly because it might be kind of hard to program his shape-shifting thing. This is no game. Too bad Black Manta isn't in this one.
Scorpion.
Now, Scorpion is only in this game because, well, it was made by the guys who made Mortal Kombat. They had to slip one of their characters in there.
Finish him!
Your soul will burn!
Still voiced by Patrick Stace in this game. I forgot he could do that. Not bad, not bad. Oh, I got a trophy for that. Since I reached level 10. And if I played the mobile version, I guess I could play as Oracle or something. I don't know. I didn't play mobile Injustice. Okay, Wonder Woman. You know, I don't remember what this costume looks like. Let's have a look. Wonder Woman versus. Let's see. Let's go to. We'll save Arkham for a little later. You know what? Let's go back to Themyscira.
Athena, guide me!
Oh, that's her number 600 outfit. Not bad. You do realize you'll have to fix those statues, Diana!
Fire El Corazon.
You're not up to this.
Does anyone know what Bane said there? I recognize Corazon, that means heart, but I don't know what else he said.
You're no match for an Amazon.
And no, her special move doesn't change just because she's on Themyscira. Those other Amazons show up no matter which stage you're on. Now then, Zatanna. Oh, I should mention Martian Manhunter, Zatanna, Batgirl, Scorpion, Zod, and Lobo were the DLC characters in the original release.
Zatanna.
Zatanna versus...
Black Adam.
Meanwhile, at the Hall of Justice...
Prepare to be astounded.
I have returned.
Begin.
Oh, I hate this move. Do the flippy thing over here. Ow. Okay. So he put me through it. Hey!
You are not my equal.
Oh dear.
Shazam!
Come on, over here. Over him. There we go. Hi, Darkseid! In your only appearance in this game.
Zatanna wins.
Magic is easy as 1, 2, 3!
Next up...
Hawkgirl. Solomon Grundy.
The stage transitions for Wayne Manor are the same whether you pick day or night. Obviously. Same with the Arkham Asylum and Joker's Asylum alternatives. Hawkgirl is probably the most inconsequential character in the game. She's really just there to fill out the roster. She's probably just here because she was in the cartoon.
Yeah.
fact, she's one of the few characters I don't remember ever getting the arcade ending for. Can't even air dash. And that's all she gets for a victory pose. Man, she's really just an aftersight in this game. And Hawkgirl don't deserve treatment like that. Alright, Shazam.
Shazam.
I mean,
Black Adam.
Did you expect anyone else? Alright, let's try Wayne Manor Knight. See if I can actually get those stage transitions off this time. The only reason I wasn't able to block that is because I was in the air. Shit, he blocked it. Oh well. We'll go into training mode after I've done a match with everybody.
Show me, boy.
You asked for it.
That's Shazam out of the way. Mostly. Next.
Green Lantern. Sinestro.
Hal Jordan is the main Green Lantern for this game, but, well, John was included as a DLC costume, but hey. Oh, and all of those villains there had their Arkham designs.
Black
Hello there, Doctor Strange. Why, yes, I did choose Injustice just because we were playing Arkham Asylum earlier. Oh, I've got how to do my super move. Sinestro, hit me! Hit me! Sinestro! Hit me! Thank you. I don't block. Ah, dang it. That knocked him out.
Once a Green Lantern, always a Green Lantern.
Oh well, someone else to do the training mode for. And finally we have Batgirl.
Batgirl.
I mean, who else was I gonna have her kick the shit out of?
The Joker.
You don't stand a chance.
Watch out, Joker! This one looks kinda tough!
Really? I think you underestimate me.
Begin.
Come on, Joker, this way. Sorry, Bruce. Barb, the super move. Oh wait, yours has to be activated in the air, doesn't it?
Hold this for me. Didn't stand a chance.
She is amazing as Oracle, and they really shouldn't have reversed it in the main comics. But at the same time, it is always nice to see Barb as Batgirl in another universe. She's always just having so much fun with it. Alright, we finished with the heroes' side, now on to the villains. Oh, wait. Come on, Doomsday. Hit me. I really shouldn't have done that enhanced version. Yeah, forget it.
You know nothing of strength.
Come on, Shazam. Come on. Hit me. Okay, show that off for me. Thank you.
Black Adam wins.
This will always be a world of dictators.
Okay.
You will know the meaning of fear. Fully charged.
Begin.
Yeah!
wins.
Not all that fearful.
You will submit!
Doomsday. Superman.
I mean, where else can a battle between Superman and Doomsday really take place? Even if I am using Cyborg Superman. Boom!
Doomsday wins.
I will destroy you all.
Has Doomsday been ever been shown to be capable of speech in the comics? I know he was capable of it in Justice League, like the show, but...
Killer Frost. Green Arrow.
That's what I call an entrance.
Begin.
You know, I don't actually know what Killer Frost's trait does.
Frost wins.
Okay, Ares.
Wonder Woman.
Behold the God of War! Athena, guide me!
Begin.
Would challenge me at my own game.
I want to save Scorpion for last. Let's go Deathstroke.
Lex Luthor.
Must I remind you of my...
Begin.
Contract fulfilled. Retrieving next target.
Catwoman. Harley Quinn.
long now. I have business to attend to.
Begin.
Go. Oh, wait, I didn't want to click retry.
Must I remind you of my superiority?
This planet will be mine.
Begin.
Meeting of the board, Project Source, and arrange pickup for the suit. Need a tune-up.
I like that outro. All right, just a few more to go. We got Grundy, Harley, Joker, Lobo, Zod, and Scorpion.
Solomon Grundy, the Joker.
Watch out, Joker!
Begin.
Yeah, kind of like Bane and Doomsday, Grundy has a hard time actually comboing, because, you know, he's slow as hell. Okay, that was funny. Okay. Harley Quinn. Or actually
Harley Quinn. The Joker.
Come on, Joker.
Joker. The Joker.
Watch out, Joker!
Begin.
Come on now.
Love this.
And Joker is one of the ones that has special lines for his mirror matches, and that wasn't one of them.
The Joker wins.
You're fired.
Fatality.
All right, 3 to go. Lobo versus
Aquaman.
Time to liven up the joint.
Begin.
Very a bastich. And he blocked that.
Game mechanics, remember?
Call me the main man for nothing.
And you know what? We've seen absolutely everything from Zod, so let's just skip him and go straight to Scorpion.
Scorpion. The Joker.
Finish him!
Your soul will burn!
Watch out, Joker! This one looks kinda tough!
Really?
I think you underestimate me.
Begin.
Come here!
Scorpion in this game plays a lot like he does in MK9. Fuck. which, when I was younger and I was playing this for the first time, that was a relief because, well, Scorpion had been my main in 9, and it was nice to know he played just the same, or mostly the same. Injustice is a little, I don't want to say stiffer than MK9, but it definitely doesn't feel as fluid. Come on, Joker, hit me. Hit me more. Okay, you know what? Let's take this over to the other way so you can do the transition. Or just do that again. Fatality. Alright, that's everybody. Now, I've got dinner waiting, so I've got to run. Thank you for tuning in, everybody. I'll play through the story mode of this game some other time.